Let's get this crazy SUV, the Honda CR-V Hybrid Racing, out in the open right now. The engineers at Honda Performance Development were in charge of this one-off project, which involved several different automobile divisions, HPD. However, a wide-body CR-V with a huge wing and a roaring engine won't be available at dealerships because it is a one-off. But this year, you will see it at a few IndyCar races. That's because this family SUV is actually a race car hidden beneath CR-V body panels, and even then, Honda isn't doing much to hide it. The lower part of the racer is made entirely of carbon fiber, with enormous fender flares and butterfly front doors that open to reveal a racing interior. The SUV's upper body is still a 6th-generation CR-V steel body, but the foundation is a bespoke tube chassis. With the exception of the enormous back wing. The back doors don't open in the way you anticipate. There, an IndyCar twin-turbocharged hybrid V6 engine with an extract 6-speed paddle-shift transmission is installed where the second row of seats would typically be. Although it is not an exact replica of the upcoming 2024 Honda IndyCar powerplant, it does provide a sneak peek. It's a hybrid, namely a 2.2-liter Honda V6 tuned to operate on Shell 100% renewable race fuel. The 800-horsepower package is confirmed by HPD President David Salters, although a detailed breakdown of power for the combustion and electric systems is not provided. The CR-V hybrid racer really uses a supercapacitor storage system instead of batteries, which improves fuel economy while improving overall power with short-term bursts of power. During a media briefing for the unique CR-V, Salters said, "The specific reason it contains supercapacitors is power. They excel at high power and are also naturally safe for this use. You can't actually hurt them, but it's also for our benefit to learn. And learning is the main reason this crazy CR-V is around." Honda has no qualms about referring to the entire project as a rolling laboratory, constructed to investigate various performance-related topics and how electrification may be included. Future racing ventures may be able to benefit from the lessons learned from the CR-V hybrid racer, but for the time being, Honda has no intentions to race their super SUV at places like Pikes Peak. Not that it wouldn't succeed on just about any course, either. The NSX GT3 race car's 15-inch Brembo brakes and front suspension are mounted on the tube frame. Dallara IR18 Indy suspension with 14-inch Brembos is found at the back. The fender flares have 285/35 series tires up front and 305/35 series tires at the back. They sit on 20-inch wheels that are 10.5 inches wide in the front and 11 inches wide in the back. For now, its objective is to research electrification, energy management, and all of these things with a view to racing, as well as potential road car use, so we'll try and use it as a lab for the time being, Salters explained. And there is no doubt that people will get a chance to see it. Starting on March 3rd at the season-opening Firestone Grand Prix of St. Petersburg, Florida, Honda will bring the CR-V hybrid racer to several 2023 IndyCar events for display and demonstration purposes.